mean, if I look at it the way it looks, it's in what we call standard form. It's definitely graphable, but you may just be used to putting it in slope-intercept form, so that's something else you could do. If I treat it like a standard form equation, I'm going to graph a line. Remember how you graph standard form equations? And standard form is we get x and y on one side added together, and then you got a number just on the other side, Cadence. Two points, right, to figure out where that line should be. We plug in a 0 for x, and what was the other thing we did?
0
for y, right? Remember that trick?
Yeah.
Kind of a cool trick. So if you plug in, it's going to be pretty easy. Plug in 0 for x, it goes away, we get y is equal, right? If you use quotes, because there's actually an inequality there. But when we're going to graph the line is what makes both sides equal, right? The points that make both sides equal. So we do want to treat it like an inequality sign for finding that line. 0, 1, and if I make y 0, then x will be equal to 1. Okay. So 0, 1, and 1, 0. 0, 1, and 1, 0. If I wanted to write it in slope-intercept form, I would subtract x from both sides and get y is greater than negative x plus 1. And now I have a line with a y-intercept of 1 and a slope of negative 1, and that's exactly what we would draw if we went with that approach as well. All right, so I'm going to draw the line being a border between the blacked out half and the not blacked out half. What kind of a line should I use? Why is that? Both sides cannot be equal, which should be yet another reminder that the line, the points on the line, make both sides equal. That is exactly what the line is. That's what it's always been. Every time you've graphed a line, it's exactly what it has been. All the points that make both sides equal. It's just that we don't like that. We don't like them to be equal in this instance. So we will graph the dotted line, which I think is actually what I have ready right now. So here we go. There's a negative one. Okay. So we have the dotted line. We don't want the points in the line to be included. That's why it's dotted. But we do want that border to be very clear and crisp, so we actually do graph that dotted line. Okay, so what is it? We're going to show you above or below?
Above.
How do you know?
Greater than.
Okay, we do need to be just a little bit careful. That applies only if we have written it in slope-intercept form and the y is by itself, right? So if y is on one side by itself and it's greater than, then yes. But you'll notice, like, the y is on this side and it's less than. You can't follow that rule just because y, like the variable y happens to be on one side and we see the inequality pointing in a certain direction. Okay. If you want to use that rule, you make sure to get y by itself and then follow that rule. Alright? It just so happens that, you know, you will shade on the correct side if you were to have done that. You did write it in slope-intercept form. Y is greater than. The greater values vertically, which is what y is, are up there, so we would shade above. So write it in slope-intercept form and use that rule. Or there's another way we can go about it to know which side to shade on. Sean?
Up on 0, 0, and 0. 0, 0.
Since it's not on the line, if it's on the line, 0, 0 is best. You don't want to use that. You want to use some other point. But it is not on the line, so we can use it. Plugging 0, 0, 0 for x, 0 for y, is that true? 0, 0, 0 plus 0,
no.
Is that greater than 1? No, it's not, so we would shade the other side, as we already have. Okay, so if you want to use what we call method 2, make sure you get y by itself. Gotta get y by itself. Okay, next, the blue line. So we have negative x minus y is less than negative 3. We could do the standard form thing, which is what it's set up for. So we can once again plug in 0 for x. 0 for y. Okay, so I plug in 0 for x, treating this like an equality sign because we're looking for the line right now. If I plug in 0 for x, I get negative y. Let's just put an equal sign there. Negative y equals negative 3. So then what would y be?
3.
3. All right. Divide by negative 1. Okay, now let's do the same, but we'll plug in 0 for y this time. No big surprise, I don't think. Negative x equals negative 3, so x is?
3.
What do you say about these two lines?
They're parallel.
So we have a situation where maybe we have no solutions. We'll have to find out, though. No solutions. Because this line is already in the shaded area of the red graph. So there's definitely going to be some solutions. 0, 3, and 3, 0. We're going to use the dotted line again, because it's not equal to. Which way do we shade now? Johnny?
Down.
Down. Why down?
Because it's plus 10.
Okay, so this speaks exactly to the little speech I gave a little while ago. We can't just say because it's less than. If we're going to say it's less than to shade below, then what do we need to make sure of? Okay, well that's kind of the source of the issue here.
Y is by itself.
Y is by itself. We get Y by itself. Okay. You know, I say that as a general rule, but it's really to address that issue. Like there's these negatives and they can mess things up, and what if I have to, in getting Y by itself, I would have to like multiply both sides by negative 1. And what do we do when we multiply both sides of an inequality by negative 1?
Flip the sign.
Flip that sign around, right? So if we want to follow the rule of less than means below and greater than means above, that only applies because of all the other stuff that I said when I was telling you that little trick, that y is on the other side of that inequality, okay? So, Cadence, are you wanting to show us how to get y by itself?
Well, just what I did was add x.
Okay, so you got negative y is less than positive x minus 3.
And then I divide by negative 1 on each side.
Negative 1 on each side, so you get this to be a positive. Sounds great. Okay, so we divide by negative 1, we get positive y. We're dividing by a negative on both sides, so we need to flip the sign around. Divide this by a negative, you get negative x. Divide this by a negative, you get positive 3. Alright, and so another way to graph this line, which we've already graphed. But now y is by itself, and it says that y is greater than. So what does that mean this side would be shaded? Above the blue line. And just like when we graphed equations and we were trying to find the solution, we were looking for the intersection. We're looking for the intersection of these two graphs, right? Think about it, there's not a lot of these graphs that don't intersect or maybe overlap is a better word. There's just this narrow little strip here that is only red. The rest, here, is red and blue, overlapping. There's only a little strip that doesn't work for both. Only this little strip is a bunch of points that only work in the red inequality and not in the blue. But all this stuff works in both. You can see because the red and the blue are touching each other. Cadence? That we wouldn't even consider that as being part of the solution, right? Because it's not the solution for either of those. All this is totally out. This thin strip here is a part that only works for red, not for blue. And this here is overlap for everything. So actually, what can we say about every solution for the blue inequality? All the solutions for the red just like contains all of the solutions for the blue. It's like completely owns all of the blue solutions. Right? And then there's just a few that, that the red owns by itself, but there's no solution that works with blue that doesn't work in red. We know that from the graphs because the two lines are parallel and the overlap is completely taking over the blue overlap. The blue black.
Isn't it infinite?
Mm-hmm.
Red, that can only work for red?
Yeah, there are infinite. That's correct. There's an infinite number of points in this narrow strip. Right, so don't forget that. There are infinitely many. But when it comes to infinities, there are different infinities. And sometimes, I don't know the answer to this question because I haven't really investigated it, but it looks like there's more solutions here than there are here in this thin strip. But they're both infinite. This is infinite and this is infinite. And sometimes infinities that one looks bigger than the other, they actually wind up being the same size. So I don't know that we would say there's more solutions that work in both than work only in the red. But it might even be the same number. I'm not sure. Sean?
So for the blue equation, you just added x, or what did you
Like what happened between here and there?
Yeah.
Okay, so yes, add x to both sides so that we cancel out the x on this side, and now we have a plus x on this side.
Okay.
And I just wrote it in reverse order, plus x minus 3.
All right.
And then divided by a negative 1, divided by negative 1 becomes positive, divided by negative 1, divided by negative 1. And when you divide by negative 1 on both sides, or a negative at all on both sides, you flip the sign around.
Okay.
And
that's why it went above, okay.
That is why it went above. Or if we left it just like this, we could again plug in 0, 0, and that'll reveal the truth as well.
If we left it as that?
As this original blue one, yeah. Because 0, 0, to add together to 0, is that less than negative 3?
Yeah.
No, okay.
0 is not, like, the right of the line. So no, it's not true, so we would shade the opposite side.
See, I did it.
Got you tested it?
Yeah, but I didn't see the negative on the 3.
There we go. All right.
That's
probably one lesson learned. That's the important part. Number 15. The other one. Negative 2x minus 5y is less than 15. The other one, negative 4x is greater than 10y plus 60. Okay. So we first need to graph both of these inequalities. To graph them, it might be easier to write them in slope-intercept form.
Mm-hmm.
Creating?
Yeah, no. Plus 2x on top form.
Okay, so you have negative 5y is less than 2x plus 15.
And on the bottom one, I did minus 60.
Minus 60. So I'm going to minus 60, and then I'm also going to kind of flip everything around so that we have the y stuff on the left and the x stuff on the right. So I'm going to subtract 60, which on this side is going to give us negative 4x minus 60. Negative 4x minus 60. Right. So putting the left on the right. And this side, this left side, is on the greater than side, so I need to keep that. Right? Still needs to be on the greater than side. And the y stuff needs to be on the less than side. So you have 10y is less than. All right. Got to do more, right, Monica?
On the top one, you divide by negative 5.
Divide by negative 5 on the top one, so that's going to give us a positive y. We're going to flip that sign around. We're going to get negative 2/5 x, and we're going to get negative 3. And the blue one. Johnny? A positive 10, so the sign will still be like that. Divide this by 10, you get negative 2/5 divide negative 60 by 10, you get negative 6. Red one, we're going to graph the, remember there's two parts to it, the line part, the blacked out half, that we shade in. It's got a line intercept at negative 3, slope at negative 2/5, that means we're going to go to the right 5, and down 2. Okay, what kind of line are we going to use?
Dotted
line, because there is dotted equal to. Alright, on to the shading part of this. Which half are we going to shade? Top. We got written all out of the slope intercept form. Y is on this side, y is greater, so we do shade above. Okay, what could you say about this next line before I even do anything?
Same slope,
so
parallel
lines. It has a y-intercept of negative 6, so it's possible that this has no solution, right? There could be this impossible overlap. There's no way they're going to overlap. Let's see what happens. It has the same slope. It's parallel. So here we go. We're going to draw a dotted line again because it does not include the points that make both sides equal. And we're shading below, right? Because y is less than. So, what happened? We got
no solutions.
There's no overlap here, no solutions. Seem to make more sense than it did when you walked in?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Make sure you're showing your work, write stuff down, don't cut corners. Make it nice and easy, nice and slow.